Hey, Fred Kelly here, your nerd sidekick, helping you look like the technology hero. And today, I want to help you clone your hard drive in your computer. So this would be specifically for cloning the drive that your computer boots from, so that it's very simple to take your old drive, basically get rid of it, and put in the new drive that we clone onto, and then immediately boot from that new drive so that you're up and running in a very short period of time without having to reinstall Windows and a bunch of other programs. So let's talk about what we're gonna learn today here. The first thing is, what is cloning? What's the difference between cloning and copying files? If you've been using Windows for any period of time at all, you've probably copied files with Windows Explorer, or what's called File Explorer now. And moving files around is something that we do all the time. You might move pictures and documents around, you copy those, move them from one drive to another or one directory to another. And you might think, well, okay, I can just, if I wanna make a copy of this drive onto another drive, it's a real simple process to just copy everything, highlight everything, and then drag it over to a new drive, and I'm done. Well, it does not work that way. The problem is there are a lot of hidden files. There are files that you can't copy with the standard File Explorer, and there are file allocation tables and maybe partitions that are on your drive. There's data that's necessary for the booting process to happen properly. And you just can't copy those things with your standard software that's built into Windows. And so what you're going to need is some cloning software that will make a one-to-one copy, byte for byte, from your old drive to your new drive, so that it sees your new drive as just like it was the old drive. So just a whole bunch of reasons why you can't do this without using some special software. The good thing is most of that software is free. We'll talk about that in a minute. But so let's talk about, first of all, what you need to actually make a cloning process happen. Well, you need a computer. I have a computer here that's a pretty old computer that I want to upgrade the boot drive in this computer. So we'll kind of make this our example project. So you need a computer, maybe a laptop. I'll talk about that a little bit. So you need the drive. This kind of represents our drive that we're copying from, the old boot drive. This is the old style drive that is super slow, and I'm going to put everything onto a new solid state drive that's much faster, no moving parts. And so that is a simple process to move these from here. And so we need the original drive and we need the new drive. One thing you need to verify before you begin is the amount of data on the drive that you are cloning. I know in my case I have about 200 gigabytes of data on this drive. The drive I'm cloning everything onto is a 500 gigabyte drive, so that's plenty of space available to clone this onto. In your case, you need to check that. Let me show you how to do that. So if you go to your drive, to your File Explorer or Windows Explorer program, and right click on the drive that you're cloning. It's probably your C drive. And then click on Properties. You can see here how much used space is on that drive. And you want to get a drive that has at least that much space available on it. We also need a way to get the files onto this drive, so that requires two things. We need power and we need a data cable. Now, if you are running a laptop and need to duplicate everything off of your laptop, I'm going to recommend that you get a cable like this, because this is very simple to do. Unless you have a laptop with an extra bay for a second hard drive, then you will need something like this to copy the files off of that laptop. In this case, with a desktop computer, you've got all the space you need to easily plug in a second drive. So, but for a laptop, if you need to copy everything off of that, clone everything off of that, let me recommend this cable. The reason this is so great is it plugs into any USB port that's on your laptop, and then this provides both power and data, and it plugs in right here on the back of this drive. and that will allow you to quickly copy everything externally. So this sits outside your laptop and makes it possible to quickly copy everything. So the next thing you need is for if you're putting everything into a desktop computer, you're going to need a little kit. At least I got a little kit here. This was $8.99 on Amazon. I'll have a link for that below. And I have a link for this cable in the description below as well. And this is about $16. And this little kit here has some the necessary power supply adapters you need, a cable for plugging in for the data. And then finally, this has a little bracket that allows you to mount this drive, because especially in older computers, the cases were not equipped to handle this size drive. They were equipped to handle this size drive. And so what this does is it fits in a bay where an old style drive would go, and allows you to put this in here, mount it to this, and then just put it in here so that it sits in there safely. And this even comes with a little screwdriver. So all the screws you need, all the power, all the data cables you need, and this would even allow you to, you could put two of the solid state drives in here. So that works quite well. Simple little kit for $8.99. And so those are the things that you need for the hardware. Now, I talked about the software a little bit ago. Almost every manufacturer of solid state drives, I checked the top 10 manufacturers and I found all but one that I could determine had some type of free software that you could download from their website that will allow you to clone your drives. And this is a lot of times it's provided by Acronis, and they just have their name on it. But one of the things that the software will do is it will scan the computer to make sure that that manufacturer's drive is somewhere in that computer. So if it sees, in this case, I've got a Samsung drive. If I was trying to use software from, let's say, Western Digital, and it saw this Samsung drive, that cloning software would not work. So you want to get the software from the manufacturer of the solid state drive that you are using. And usually that somewhere in the box that comes with that, there'll be instructions on where to go and download that free software. Now let's talk about why you might want to do this. There's a couple reasons really for wanting to clone a drive. Number one, if you want to get rid of this old style drive that's slow, then that's a great reason to upgrade to a solid state drive, which could be quite a bit faster in your computer. The other reason is if you had a drive that you just felt like it was starting to get old and you were concerned that it may be going bad soon, you could clone that drive and then have a backup of exactly where you are, where your computer was that day when you made that clone. And so if the boot drive that you had in there ever went bad, you could take the clone that you made, drop it into the computer, and it should be off and running without any hitches. So in this case, I am going to install everything into this desktop computer. And so I don't need this, although if you wanted to do a desktop computer, make your clone using this type of cable, as long as you got a USB port, you could do it this way. So I don't need that for now. And this is just as a prop. So I'll put that out of the way. And so what I'm going to do now is I need to connect this solid state drive to this computer. And so what I have to do is I need to I'm going to open this SATA cable. This is the style of, this is a serial ATA connection that this solid state drive has on the back here. It's just this very short little plug here. And so I could very easily just plug that in here. That plugs in just like that. And then the next thing that I have to do is I need to know a couple of things about this particular computer. This is a computer I built back in 2007, so it's a little long in the tooth, but I feel like I can probably get a little bit more use out of it for some kind of server here in the house. And so if I can upgrade the boot drive, I think I'll get a little more life out of it. Certainly run a little bit faster. But to understand what type of plugs for SATA are on the motherboard, it helps if you have, I've got the original manual that came with this computer. If you still got one of these, you can grab it and quickly you should be able to find out some things about the SATA ports that are in your computer. But if not, you can probably go online, just look up the motherboard if you have that, and find out what the ports are that are on this computer. So in my case, if you look here, right back there, these are the SATA ports. And what we have in this case are, we've got 7 ports. The main thing you're trying to do here is you want to plug this into the fastest SATA port on your motherboard. There are computers with more than one version of SATA ports on them. That's why you need to check your manual. There are SATA 1, 2, and 3. 3 is the fastest, so if you have a 3, plug into that. You also want to avoid plugging into ports if they're designated for use in RAID. So again, just check your manual, plug into the fastest port available, and you're good to go. So let's just go ahead and plug in here to one of these ports. And I can see these purple ports right here. Let's get the glasses. A common theme in my videos will be, let's get the glasses. Okay, so I'm plugging in. And you can hear it click. Pretty simple click in there. All right, and so you can see this new red cable here is plugged into that bottom right port. It really doesn't matter which one you put them in, because in my case anyway, they're all the same speed. So I've got the SATA data cable on here. The next thing I need to do is provide power. And so I've got different cables in here for power already just a part of this computer. You want to look for one that's a little slim, has a little slot here, and there's going to be, in most cases, just a couple of types of cables that are coming out of your power supply. So you may have one that has 4 little openings. That's called a Molex connector, and the type you need in this case is just called a SATA power connector. And so this little kit that I got here, if you don't have the SATA power connector, which could be the case if you're running an older style computer, there would be here a converter that would allow you to plug in. This plugs into the Molex style power connector, and then that converts into a connector that is made to fit into most or all of these types of drives. So there we go. So now I have connected the power supply and the data to this drive. And so, I mean, really I'm done in terms of just making the initial connection to begin the cloning process. So this is, can just sit here just like this. Obviously you want to be careful with it, but it doesn't have to be mounted yet into the computer to do the cloning. So now I'm going to show you how to do the cloning process, so take a look. Okay, here we are in Windows, and yes, if you're wondering, this is Windows XP. It's a really old computer. I don't use this online, and so it's not a risk, but if you have Windows XP, you need to upgrade it quickly. Just a quick public service announcement. So I'm going to start the data migration software from Samsung. Just as a reminder, you need to download the cloning software that is provided by the manufacturer of your specific brand of solid-state drive. So check the box that your solid-state drive came in, or go to their website and look for that. So this is just an example of what this software looks like for the Samsung version, but it's going to be very similar for most any type of cloning software that you use. So let's open this up. If you have ever worked with drives before, you may be wondering if you need to format the drive like you would normally do with the new drive. The answer is no.
You can take this right out of the box and plug it into your computer and begin using the cloning software. It will, in essence, format the drive during the cloning process. So I'm going to click the start button here. And what you see here right away is the source disk. This is the disk that's already in the system. This is the old hard drive I am going to be cloning. And it just so happens to be a Samsung. I'm going to be cloning onto another Samsung disk, so don't let that confuse you. This is a hard drive, the old one. And so just a little information here, if you had multiple drives, you would see, maybe if you had an E drive, for example, you might see that here. But in this case, I just have the one hard drive that I will be cloning from. And so you can see it tells you here it's 465.8 gigabytes. And this drive has currently just under 200 gigabytes on it. And so that kind of is indicated by this. If this was nearly full, you'd see this blue bar way out here. And so this is our target drive. This is the Samsung solid state drive that I'm going to be cloning everything onto. And you can see it's telling you this one actually is the same capacity drive as this one, just coincidentally. And so it shows you here, once the cloning process is completed, I'm going to have the same 199.8 gigabytes of data on this drive. That's a real simple look at what you're starting from, what your source is, and what your target is. So now I just need to click the start button. And it gives me a little warning that anything on this drive back here, this new target drive, is going to be deleted. Make sure you're looking at the right drive, that your target drive is truly the one that you want to be putting everything onto, because anything on this drive gets erased. In other words, if you have any files at all on the target drive, the drive we're cloning onto, all those files will be erased and replaced by the files and data on the source drive that we are cloning. So if your target drive is not a new blank drive, be forewarned that your existing files will be erased on the target drive. If you are cloning onto a new blank drive, you have absolutely nothing to worry about here. And it does warn you that anything that's open won't be cloned. So if you have programs that are running, it would be best to close those. So the next thing we need to do is click the yes button. All right, so the cloning process has begun here. And so I'm gonna just let this run. I'll come back once the process is over. All right, so we're coming in for a landing here. You can see we're almost done with the cloning process. And it's gonna end up taking somewhere around 48 minutes. All right, the cloning process is complete. The C drive has been copied to the new solid state drive. The next step is for me to shut down the computer. I will pull the electrical plug off of the back of the original old hard drive. That is something I'm going to show you how to do here in just a minute. Our drive is now cloned. We just need to make sure when the next time we boot this computer that it boots from this drive and not the old drive. The simplest way to do that is to literally pull the plug. And we're going to pull out the electric cable from the old drive. So right now the computer is off. Do this when it's off. And I'm going to reach in there. Here's my old drive. And there's a power cable in the back of that drive. I'm just going to pull that out. And you can see here's my cable now. It's unplugged. The data cable's still in there. It doesn't matter. It's not going to hurt anything because there's no power to that drive. So when we reboot this computer, it should boot to this drive. There are some cases where that might not happen. You may have to make some adjustments to the BIOS, but that is beyond the scope of this video. So check out YouTube if you're having trouble getting it to boot correctly from this drive. Once you restart, you can find a video, I'm sure, on how to adjust your BIOS settings. Well, hopefully that wasn't too painful. Hopefully you didn't have any glitches along the way and that went smoothly. But you've made it, and so now there's really only one step left to do, and that's to put the drive into the computer. If you have a laptop, you'll need to determine whether or not you have more than one drive bay.
If you have just one drive bay, you're going to have to remove the old hard drive and replace it with this. The way to do that is going to depend on your laptop. So that's beyond the scope of this video, but somebody out there's probably made a video that will show you how to remove a hard drive and replace it. So look for that on YouTube or in other places, and you should be able to get your drive permanently installed in your laptop very easily. So in my case, the thing that I've got to do now is I just need to remove the power cable and remove the data cable, and then I'm going to grab the bracket that I purchased, and I've got some screws here to go with that. This has four holes around the edge of the disc. I can put that in here and mount that to this bracket. It doesn't matter which direction you put this into the bracket. This bracket will slide in to the computer case in either direction. So you can just line that up here. And you want to look into the little baggie here. There should be some screws that are a little shorter and fatter perhaps. So I've got four little screws. So you have to just line up the hole here with the screw hole on the side of the solid state drive. This little screw, you might want to make sure, just check your screws beforehand so that you can figure out which screws will fit in here. And so you can see there, that one goes in, it just slides in there real smoothly. The other screws are meant for mounting this into the computer itself. So now I'm just going to insert this into the side here. And if you have your little screwdriver, and getting these to line up for the first time can be a little bit of a challenge. But once you get the first one started, that makes everything go easier. So there we go, that's driving on in there. And then I can, I'm actually gonna rotate it around and do one on the opposite side, so that way we'll have one on either side. And then the next one should go in a lot better, a lot smoother, a lot easier. That's it. Okay, so I'm just going to wrap up. I'm going to go ahead and put the other two in, and we'll take it from there. So we've got the solid-state drive mounted in the bracket. The next thing we have to do is just decide where in the computer I'm actually going to place this. And if you've never worked on a computer before, don't worry. There's no magic about this. There's no right or wrong. There's just good, better, and best, perhaps. And so you're just going to find a bay within this section here. And your computer may be different. This is an older style case. So you may have places down here where these drives may mount. So it's just going to depend on your case. But in the case of my case, I'm going to just pick a place here where I'm comfortable mounting this. You have to be aware of, first of all, which side the connections are on. So I want to make sure when I put this in that the connections for the power and the data are sticking out in this direction, because the wires will be coming this way into the back of the drive. So that's kind of the main thing I have to think about, the orientation of this. And if I pick one of these slots, I need to be able to easily get it in there. And you may have devices in your installed in your computer already. For example, this graphics card here is pretty large. It can make it a little difficult to slide a drive into one of the bay slots. So I just have to think, okay, I think right here, it's a pretty good place. I should be able to slide this in and get that in there without too much struggle. So pick the spot you want and just go for it. And so let me show you how to do that next. So I'm ready to mount this into the computer. And before I do that, one of the things I want to look at is the bracket itself and determine what holes I'm going to be inserting the screws into. So you can see along here, you got 1, 2, 3 screw holes where that will go. So let me go ahead and insert this into the slot here and get that on pushed into the computer. I have the mounting bracket inserted here into the case. It's sticking out just a little bit. That's fine. Two of the holes that were on the side of the bracket are here and here. And so the next step I have is just to take the screws here that are meant for that, for mounting onto the bracket itself. Again, there are two different kinds of screws in this little kit, and there's sizes that are specifically meant for going into the side of the bracket, not into the side of the solid state drive. So I'm going to pull those out. I'm going to insert two screws here and on the back side as well. So let me do that real quickly. I have the mounting bracket securely fastened to the case itself, and really all that's left to do is to connect the data cable and the power cable. So I'm going to find the power cable that I'd like to use. Again, you may be using this type of adapter. In my case, I don't need that, so all I'm going to do is connect the power cable back to the drive, and then connect the data cable to the drive itself. And so those are connected now. So at that point, you're done. You may want to do a little cleanup of your cables. You always want to think about the airflow within the case. If you can reduce obstructions, that's always a good thing. You may have lighting that you want to worry about if you're displaying the inside of your case to the room, but in my case, I'm not. So all I have to do now is put the sides of the computer back on and turn it on, just make sure everything works. Well, there you have it. Hopefully this was a project that went smoothly for you without any glitches. And I hope you see improvements in the speed of your computer if you're upgrading to a solid state drive. In my case, my computer boots now in about 30 seconds versus about a minute and a half. So it was a project well worth the time and the expense. But if this is the kind of thing you're interested in seeing more of this type of thing in the future, I'd appreciate it if you'd subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up on this video and let your friends know to check out Nerd Sidekick.